So in this video, I'm going to show you how to balance chemical equations. In this example, I'm going to show you what happens when you mix iron, which is Fe, with oxygen, which is the O2, and when they react together, you get the compound Fe2O3, or what is more commonly known as rust. So this is a good example to show what happens when you leave your bicycle in the rain. Your bicycle, which is made mostly of steel, and steel is 95% iron, and the iron mixes with the rain, which is just water, and water contains oxygen. So the iron and the oxygen react together, and then you get this annoying brown substance on your bike, which is Fe2O3, or what you know as rust. So let's get started right away and start balancing this equation. So first, let's start with the iron. We need to have the same number of iron on the left-hand side as we do on the right-hand side. So notice on the left-hand side we have one atom of iron, and on the right-hand side we have two atoms of iron. So since we need to make them equal, I'm going to put two molecules of iron on the left-hand side. So now let's do the same thing for the oxygen. Notice on the left-hand side how we have two atoms of oxygen. And on the right-hand side, we have three atoms of oxygen. We need to make this equal. So on the left-hand side, I'm going to multiply the two atoms of oxygen with 1.5 molecules. 1.5 times 2 is equal to 3. And on the right-hand side, we also have 3. So now our oxygens are balanced. So now we have the same exact number of iron and oxygen on the left-hand side as we do on the right-hand side. So are we finished with this problem? The answer to that question is no, because we can never have half a molecule. Notice how we have 1.5 molecules of oxygen. So how do we get rid of half of a molecule? The answer to that question is multiply both sides by 2. So that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by 2. So let's start with the iron. Notice how we have 2 molecules of iron. 2 times 2 is equal to 4. So now we have 4 molecules of iron. So now let's move on to the oxygen. Notice how we have 1.5 molecules of oxygen. If we multiply 1.5 times 2, that gives us 3 molecules of oxygen. And whatever you do to one side, you need to do to the other side. So now we need to multiply the right side by 2. Notice how we have 1 molecule of rust on the right-hand side. 1 times 2 is equal to 2. So now we have 2 molecules of rust on the right-hand side. So now we have completely balanced the equation, but let's double-check just to make sure that we got the right answer. Notice on the left-hand side how we have 1 atom of iron being multiplied by 4 molecules, so we have 4 total iron. And on the right-hand side, we have 2 atoms of iron being multiplied by 2 molecules, so we also have 4 total iron. So now let's double-check our oxygen. Notice on the left-hand side how we have 2 atoms of oxygen being multiplied by 3 molecules, so we have 6 total oxygen. And on the right-hand side, we have 3 atoms of oxygen being multiplied by 2 molecules. So we also have 6 total oxygen. So now we have double-checked our answer. We have 4 irons and 6 oxygens on the left-hand side, and we also have 4 irons and 6 oxygens on the right-hand side. Now this is an easier example. I'm going to be making some more videos on some more difficult examples, so stay tuned. I hope this video helped out, so until my next one, I will see you later.